Hey there, welcome to the Breakfast Club. There isn't a piece of poetry or a lyric to a song that I feel sums up the social pressures that we feel more than some excerpts from the song Come As You Are by Nirvana. So let's look at some of these things. And it's just a few. I mean, it's not, there aren't that many lyrics to the song, but come as you are, as you were, as I want you to be. Now, those things seem like three distinct things, but in our brains, like when you think of someone, there are symbols that represent that person, and they're a combination of what you want them to be, what they've been in the past, and what they currently are. And then there's also what you imagine them to be in the future. All of those things. It's multiple things, but it's also one thing in your head. It's still just one person in your head. Take your time, hurry up. The choice is yours, don't be late. Sounds like how I feel every time I want to be somewhere. Come as a trend, as a friend, as an old enemy. Well, sometimes the line between friend and enemy becomes painfully thin. Social pressures can really suck. And they're worse than ever with these things. All these social mobile apps. It has integrated itself into our everyday lives, into every facet of our beings. It has made us more polarized than ever. It has brought out the most negative sides to tribalism. I mean, we're always going to be tribalist. So it's just part of our experience. But there are some things that we can be tribalist about, and it doesn't really hurt anything. And there are some things we can be tribalist about, and it's really messed up. And the route that we've gone since social media has taken over so many people's lives is a very negative one. It takes all the things that we normally keep to ourselves or only keep to a specific tribe, so to speak, and puts it out in the open. And then anyone who disagrees, you cast them out. These contradicting social pressures are more powerful than ever. School shootings are at an all-time high. People are feeling more disenfranchised than ever. People have more of a voice than ever. And yet, people feel more powerless than ever. And this is all while we are experiencing the glue no longer holding our society together. We're losing our morality. It's like we've convinced ourselves that we don't need such things. And I'm not talking about some sort of religious morality with strict rules. I'm talking about the idea that we treat people the way we would wish to be treated if we were that other person. The idea that we occasionally figuratively try on other people's shoes. The idea that if you treat others decently, they're more likely to treat you decently. And seriously, we've lost a lot of that. It's a real shame. And it's looking like the only force with any sort of strength that's trying to do anything about that are religious ones. I mean, I'm glad that there is at least something trying to bring balance back into the picture. I just wish it was from more secular of sources. As a result of this, I see religion picking up steam over the next few years. But who knows? I just know that in the online world, there have been way too many atheists, way, way too many, who just don't seem to have any morals anymore. Fuck your feelings. Yeah, if you're at that point where you're saying you're putting out a message of fuck your feelings, you've lost. Yes, I understand that you're trying to get some sort of fact across to someone, but if you're not considering their feelings, then you don't actually care if they understand, because if you really want them to be able to latch on to what you're trying to say, then you would care about their feelings and you would try to find a way to tell them whatever this is in a way that's that might actually have a chance of reaching them without just going out of your way to hurt them. If you know something's going to hurt someone, you know, why do it? Well, they, fuck their feelings. No, you're a piece of shit if that's what you're doing to people. And unfortunately, I see that happening when it comes to online, particularly on YouTube, Twitter, some places on Facebook. I'm seeing atheists just not giving a shit about other people. It's just weird how everything seems to be unraveling right now. The right is acting like the left is acting like the right. The non-religious are bullying the religious, and it's cool to spout anti-white racism now. Everything is upside down, and people seem to be acting like, well, that's the answer to the way things were. What, to just make it just as shitty, but just flip it around? That's not an answer. And I said, all of this the while we lose our morality. What have we become? Anyway.